back to this mellow kind of groove, you know what I'm saying? Kick a little story, check it out. I remember back in the day, way back when, I knew this girl, they called her Ren. She was kind of a fly dame. The only problem was she had a guy's name. But that didn't really matter to me, 'cause I had to have her, you see. I had somewhat of a strategy, and nobody's strategy was quite as bad as me. 'Cause I'm not the typical. I got a dick that can rip a girl, rip a pussy wide open, and have her wishing and hoping that she would be dead soon. 'Cause I work miracles when it comes to the bedroom. So I stepped to her, and the first thing in my mind was, how soon could I do her? I acted just like I knew her. I walked up to her and just had to pursue her. I said, hello, your butt is bouncing and your titties are shaking like jello. I gotta get with you. She said, not if you spit or do anything that you have to do. Then I turned around and just laughed at you, you little bitch. I remember, I think the month was December. It was kinda snowy, the scene was not green, it was lawn-mowy. I don't know what that means, but I knew that this girl could get loose and tight and mean. She could get looser than a diver goes. Now here's the live part. I started throwing words. She thought they were quite absurd. I said, nah, I just gotta kick it to you. Next thing I know I'm doing it. We were in my room. I was banging her head on the headboard and soon I had a scream, and she was scheming of a way to get out. I said, bitch, you must be dreaming. Ain't no way you're getting out of this. My dick is so hard, it's like I have to take a morning piss. You know how that goes. So I had to bang it to the hole. I put it to her like this. I said, excuse me, miss, would you like to do it this way forever? And she said, no, never. I gotta get out of this place. She tried everything, she even smacked me in the face. But I was too busy screwing and doing what I felt I was doing and what had to be done. There was no way she could run, 'cause I was having too much fun. And I wouldn't stop for nothing, I ain't bluffing. This pussy was toughing. It was kinda roughing me up, but that's alright, 'cause I was scuffing it up. I was splitting that pussy, 'cause I ain't no wussy. I like to do what a real man can do, an avalanche of girl. Stick my dick so far upper, it comes out of nose. That's what I like to do to hoes. They think they're bad and they can last in bed. Well, try a night with me, little girl. You ain't ready for this, kid, 'cause I got a rhyme that can just did anything that I can do. You can do better? Well, that's poo. Just let me kick out to this mellow beat and listen to a fly young fellow speak. 'Cause I'm kicking the syllable. I got a dick that can kill a bull just by smacking him in his head and make his eyes turn red and drop dead. But I'm getting off the subject. I gotta tell you about what I did to this fly female. Excuse me while I give you the details. One more time, I gotta kick and talk about the shit that I did to this chick. And the next day, she was walking the opposite way, 'cause she did never wanna cross my path again, or she feel the wrath of Eminem. 'Cause I'm so funky, and I'm so spunky, I'm getting off like a junkie. She was feeding for a dick, but not mine, 'cause mine was too big. She said, next time, it won't be in bed with you. I said, bitch, you better give me head, or get done up. And if you try to run up, I'm gonna just gun up. Anyways, I got another story. Listen up, a cookie kind of glory. So young kids better close your ears, and adults, listen close, because here's another rhyme about a girl. She thought that she could rock my world. I said the only rock I'm talking about is my cock. So you better start walking about 50 paces in the opposite direction, or you're gonna feel this erection right upside your goddamn head. You fucking bitch, I'll smack you so hard you'll drop dead. She just laughed, she said I couldn't outlast her. I said, bitch, give me the ass, I'll blast her with a bottomless cock. I messed up, but that's okay. A bottomless pussy, she said she had, but I said, nah. You ain't got a bottomless trap. You better quit flapping your trap, or I'm gonna snap. She said, let's hit the bedroom, and we'll see who's gonna be praying to be dead soon. I said, alright, we went upstairs. She went to the bathroom and did her hair. She started curling her pussy hairs, that's what I mean. Then she put on her old pair of jeans that were kinda ripped, so she could take them off fast, and that ass was equipped. But my dick was equipped to rip shit, cause I was about to split that pussy wide open. I said, bitch, look, my fly's open, and I'm ready to stick it to ya. She just laughed, she said, I'm gonna kick it to ya. I said, alright, and I just collapsed on the bed, and waited for the lapse in this marathon to begin. Me against that little bitch, that little woman. I like to call a girl instead, cause she had a pussy and a swollen head. Anyways, here it goes. The gun sounded and I began to bang the hoe. But she was working wonders too. I said, damn, I didn't understand how she was doing this. But that's alright, I wasn't about to ruin this kind of mood that I was in. I finally met my match, a freaking fried woman. We were doing it and doing it and doing it until we couldn't do it no more. That's a lie. I could do it until the last day on earth. Now take that for what it's worth. And I fucked this bitch so hard, she thought she was having a birth. She thought she was having a child, cause I was getting so damn wild, but she smiled. This pussy couldn't be tamed, I said, damn, it's hotter than a flame. And she's burning my dick, I gotta learn real quick what to do. I'm getting smashed by this fucking pussy, cause it was really starting to push me. All over the bed, I was hitting my head on the headboard, I thought I was gonna be dead. This bitch was fucking me, she really stuck it to me when she began to do me. Anyways, I gotta go on and tell you about a little bit more in the song. As we were doing it, cause I wasn't about to ruin it, I wasn't about to spoil this, but the bitch was starting to boil. I said, damn, it's getting too hot in this room. I turned on the fan, and that was not enough. And soon, we were both sweating up a puddle. Then I felt like I had to guzzle the whole entire Atlantic Ocean. This bitch was finally moving so fast she was going in motion. Turned to a blur, things started to occur. I just grabbed onto her and started holding her. This pussy was starting to just mold me, so I rolled over her, and I got on top and began to rock the cock. Yeah. Yeah. Part 2 is coming up. Now let me tell you about what I did to this butt. I started banging it and banging it. I don't think this girl can hang with it, but she surprised me. She made me rise right in front of my eyes and me. I couldn't really think straight. All I know is this pussy was great. Could it be that I finally met my match? Or could it be this was the wrong snatch to get into, cause I didn't like to get done? by a bitch that was doing me instead, and I wanted to run. I wanted to break north, cause this pussy was getting so old, and of course, I was sweating. I wasn't ready for what I was getting, but that's okay, I was going steady. Steadily pounding, and all you could hear was the sound of the bed squeaking while I was freaking. I pulled my dick out and smacked her cheek. She just laughed again. She said, now you're gonna feel the wrath of a real woman. Then she growled, sounding like a panther out on the prowl. She started fucking so hard, I thought I was gonna come a yard. Then I just slipped. Smash! There went my dick. Broke it in half. That was pretty sad. Nah, don't laugh. Cause it can happen to you, my friend. If you ever met your match, got in bed with a real woman who was doing you instead, that's when I died in bed. Yeah, that's when I died in bed. That's when I died in bed. That's when I died in bed.